What's up, team? This is Frank, and this is a quick and dirty review of Rez Infinite. When this game first came out, a lot of people were saying that the ending made them cry. Now, I can safely admit that I cry at most Disney Pixar movies, but that's only because I'm not a monster. So I wanted to see what this game was about. But before we can talk about Area X, which was made for VR, we have to talk about the original Rez, since you'll need to play through these levels to unlock it. So the original 2001 Rez is a rail shooter, which matches actions on screen with the sounds of the music. Although you're free to look around in VR, the game will snap your focus when and where it needs to be, and it's actually impressive how the attacks mesh so well with the beats and crescendos of the music. Aiming is everything in this game. You can't dodge enemy attacks, but you can shoot them down. This means the gameplay involves finding and shooting the vulnerable blinking geometric shapes on the enemies. Doing so will propel you through the level, which gives you more to shoot and look at. I found the early levels to be rather tame, but things started to ramp up around Area 4 when the enemy boss and music decided to go into beast mode. The last level in the game tries to play with some existential questions, which really confused me at first. I began to wonder if I was doing the right thing by attacking everything in my path, since the text between areas seemed to be painting humans as warmongers. I started to wonder if I was playing the game all wrong, like maybe there's a true pacifist ending. Undertale was the only game where I played a pacifist run and actually liked it. Was Rez going to be the second game to blow my mind about this stuff? No. I found the game tutorial, which actually gives you a lot of information about the gameplay and the story. So apparently humans have created an advanced AI named Eden, and the information it was being fed, as well as a virus that infected her, fostered some cognitive dissonance, so she thought it wise to sort of killed herself? But you don't want that. So you go in like a hacker who needs to infiltrate the system and murder all the viruses and firewalls you come across. As you play, you can pick up these power-ups. These red things grant you overcharge. Each use will automatically shoot down all enemies and projectiles for a short time. This is great when you're getting overwhelmed by numbers. And these blue things fill up your evolution bar. Each time you fill this bar up, your avatar evolves from Virtual Boy graphics to the polygon era to this enlightened dancing man to, this thing? It's an atom, right? Now, I didn't really mind playing through the original Rez too much, but there was one problem with the controls that I had trouble forgiving. You see, the game allows you a lot of controller options, but I wanted to play with my VR hand controller. You can lock onto a maximum of 8 units by holding down the trigger, whereas rapidly clicking will fire at near infinite attack speed. You can track enemies by looking at them, and the VR controller allows you to further direct your laser pointer around your view. Unfortunately, the controllers fire like wands, which kinda sucks since I would rather fire a laser gun than fire like Harry Potter, but whatever, I can roll with it. The real problem is that the laser pointer is fixed within the confines of your HMD's views, which I've outlined as around here. If you look behind yourself while pointing your controller forward, the game will push your aimer with your view, which messes up with your calibration. At first, it will surprise you that your laser sight suddenly moved 2 feet to the side, but don't worry, all you have to do is aim your controller towards the invisible wall on that side, and it will gently push the reticle back into the center. Or you can just play on the monitor the way the game was originally intended. Sure, I'm glad I figured out this workaround for the controller aiming problem, but this is the last level and it took me this long to figure this out. But whatever, I really enjoyed the music in the game. It has a Fatboy Slim and Daft Punk vibe with its catchy and repetitive beats and lyrics. The last two levels in particular really got me moving, and luckily after hitting those two high notes, the game will reward you with Area X, which is a much improved experience. In Area X, some things are simplified, like the missing overdrive, and for some reason, you can't get the final or baby evolution levels from the original. Using a hand controller worked really well for several reasons. First, I was able to play with just one controller, and that makes for some casual VR gaming right there. Second, the camera follows my gaze, and the game allows me to move freely about the 3D space. The controller never lost calibration, and aiming and picking off targets was easy. Maybe a little too easy. Which is a good segue for my third point. Area X isn't hard. It's less of a game and more of a shoot these things and come along for this sweet musical ride experience. Now, both the original Rez and Area X come in the regular and traveling variety, which is impossible to lose at apparently, but the original Rez is pretty easy in VR, and Area X is easier by far. I would have instead preferred a mode with twice as many enemy spawns, since killing enemies sounds dope most of the time. Oh, and the ending to Area X gave me that same, am I doing the right thing by attacking feeling, but not for the same poignant reasons that the regular Rez made me feel. No, I really have no idea what was going on in Area X, but I knew one thing, I freaking liked it, and I wish there was more of it. And that's it. That's everything you need to know about Rez Infinite. In the end, it was an amazing, beautiful experience, but the name Rez Infinite is a misnomer. I beat the original Rez levels in around an hour of play, and I can easily beat Area X in under 20 minutes. In fact, I've had some of my non-gamer friends beat Area X on their first try. But you didn't buy this game because you're a gamer. No, it's nice knowing that you have a game in your library that amazes people and doesn't put stress on your hardware as much as games like Gorn do. If you're looking for a beautiful, interactive musical experience, which also works well to show off VR to others, you'll really like Rez Infinite. If you want a long game with tons of replay and collectibles, you won't find it here. But you might pick it up if you find it on a crazy sale just to try out this beautiful visual and musical feast. For my part, when I jump back in after a long hiatus, I'm reminded about what I love about this game. And that's the ever-building sound and splendor, which reaches a powerful finale that didn't make me cry per se, but for sure got me to the tipping point where I could have cried or laughed out loud, and that's a powerful emotion to be evoked from a video game. And remember, this was a quick and dirty review of Rez Infinite.